This Disney DVD is enhanced with Disney's Fast Play. Your movie and a selection of bonus features will begin automatically. To bypass Fast Play, select the main menu button at any time. Fast Play will begin in a moment.
Every day, they put their lives on the line. It takes honor, trust, and bravery to earn your wings.
All aircraft, we've got a wildfire north of Pinecone Ridge.
Come on, boys! Let's load up!
Go time.
Let's see what you got.
They fly in.
There she burns, fellas!
When others fly out.
That was awesome! What do you say we kick it up a notch?
The crew.
Rip it!
The proud.
Hang on!
The planes.
Brace yourself!
Hey, Sugar Rims. You just fall out of a B-17? Because you're the bomb.
Pickup trucks.
Mm-hmm. Bullseye!
Ooh. Hello.
First time ever on Blu-ray, Disney's original musical classic, The Jungle Book. The timeless story of Mowgli, a boy left in the wild.
So you're the man cub. Crazy.
Baloo, the bear that raised him.
Nothing or nobody is ever gonna come between us.
And a friendship that lasted a lifetime.
Look for the bare necessities, the simple bare necessities.
Now, digitally restored for the first time in high definition, The Jungle has never looked this good.
It's beautiful, ain't it?
And your favorite songs have never sounded better.
The bare necessities of life will come to you.
I like being a bear.
That's my boy.
Disney's high-flying, swinging, singing adventure. The Jungle Book Diamond Edition. For the first time ever on Disney Blu-ray and digital. Only for a limited time.
Yeah, man.
430 into approximately 10,000.
Check this out. This is an F-9F Panther. These things were built in about 1947, flew to about 1951-52.
Landing gear's big.
That's the thing that you'll notice about Navy aircraft. So this is the very first successful jet to launch off of aircraft carriers, and they used them in the Korean War.
I was just finishing my last movie, working with John Lasseter, and he asked, you know, what would you like to do next? And I said, well, there's a few ideas I've been working on, you know, possibly maybe a trains movie.
It was not set in the Cars world. It was its own thing because there were humans in it. It was set in the West.
And he thought that was a cool idea, and I sort of pursued that a little bit.
The more I started thinking about it, the more I thought, I wonder if there's a bigger idea here. So flying down from Northern California to Burbank, I had this epiphany. In the world of Cars, I always thought that every kind of vehicle could be a character. I thought, what if we started doing a series of films that told the stories of those characters? So I got off the airplane, and I called Clay right away.
And the phone rings, and it's John. And he's like, Clay, he goes, I have this idea. What do you think about, I know you're working on the trains thing, but what do you think about if we switched it from trains to planes? I told him, John, if there's one thing I love more than trains, it's planes. I've always been an airplane nut. I've loved airplanes from practically the day I was born.
My feet on the pedals. My hand on the throttle. Wow.
My dad loved airplanes, loved everything about it. And he rolled that into a brief stint while he was in the U.S. Navy, and he flew for the Navy.
What makes this airplane really, really cool for us is this is the plane that Grandpa Riley flew in. Now, it's unfortunate you guys never got a chance to meet him. This is my connection with my dad because of all the photographs that I have when he was in the Navy. It's with this airplane.
My dad, his dad, Grandpa, they grew up in Dayton, Ohio, which is the birthplace of flight.
Take a look at this. You guys know what this is?
Wright Brothers plane.
Wright Brothers plane.
That's right. It's the Wright Flyer. First plane that actually flew. Kitty Hawk. What's kind of cool about the whole Wright Brothers story is they were bicycle guys, if I remember correctly. Their shop was in Dayton, Ohio. That's where Grandpa was born, Dayton, Ohio. He often would tell me that, you know, he was destined to fly because he was from the birthplace of flight.
My grandpa taught my dad how to fly at a very early age, he learned.
I think the original is in the Smithsonian, but it's pretty cool that we're able to come here to Chino, California, and actually see a Wright Flyer in its all its glory.
What Clay has brought to the project because of his family, because of that aviation is in his blood, is that he brought authenticity.
I also think his attention to detail with it is just beyond what you would think. He just has this natural instinct with aviation, having grown up around it, that it definitely like shows itself throughout the work in the film.
even though it's an animated movie and we have eyes and things like that, you still want to embrace as much authenticity as you possibly can.
One of the things I believe in so strongly in all the films we create, but especially Cars and Cars 2, we want to get every detail correct.
With John, it's all about research, research, and a little more research.
That's one of the hallmarks of, you know, his methodology is to, you know, learn from the people who actually do this, because he feels like the best stories come out of research.
I had an amazing opportunity to meet with World War II veterans and Korean War veterans, with civilian pilots, and then we met with crop dusters. John felt very strongly that we would meet with our corporate pilots, the Disney corporate pilots. We all sat down and I said, okay, I'm gonna have this type of aircraft, this dusty aircraft, but he needs to fly around the world. Where is he gonna need to go to be able to make this happen? And they helped chart a course, understanding his flight characteristics and the weight of his aircraft of where he would need to go to refuel. And that's actually what informed our race routes.
A dead sprint across the North Atlantic.
That's right, Brent. This is how it works.
And then on top of that, we actually were able to go to several different locations.
We set out doing a number of research trips, going to the Reno Air Races, the Dayton Air Show, different air museums.
What's really cool about airplanes as a start, they're vast in design. They all have different personalities. Even as a kid, going to air shows with my dad or being at the runway, I could tell there were like timid airplanes out there that are a perfect example of a plane that might be scared to fly high.
He's off the pitch, nose down.
Jump on up in there.
It was a lot of fun for me to sit there and listen to my dad, who would talk about the characteristics of the airplanes as they would fly over or as they would taxi out in front of us. I have actually passed that sort of on with my sons.
And you know, if you got your feet on the pedals there, you can actually feel a little play, you know, you feel how they're moving left, back and forth. And then of course you got your stick here.
What things in the movie relate to Grandpa?
Several that come to mind right away are, you know, he was a member of the Jolly Roger Squadron. I still have his flight suit at home. And, you know, that's that iconic sort of skull and crossbones look. Now, in our movie, we planified that idea. We took the skull and crossbones and made them a piston and cross wrenches, and we call it the Jolly Wrenches. One of the other ones was that, you know, the name of our mentor character, the tough love guy, is Skipper Riley. Well, Grandpa's name was Riley. So that's how that sort of worked into the equation there.
We knew that our story was going to start in the Midwest of the United States and then eventually go global. So we were able to take this trip and we hit all these different little airfields.
We did a big tour across Minnesota, visiting all these little airfields that aren't even on the map sometimes.
We were able to find an abandoned airfield cut right out of a cornfield. And we were like, man, that's Prop Wash Junction right there. We found an abandoned fuel truck, sort of a rigged together fuel truck. He was overgrown in some bushes and we took pictures of him and he was our inspiration for Chuck.
There you go, Sparky. You're all set.
Catch you later, Chuck.
Sure thing.
So this is the F4U Corsair. And one of the reasons why I picked this for the movie was it's probably, to me, one of the most iconic airplanes of the Second World War, primarily because of that gull wing shape on the wings. You know, you could see these guys from about 2 miles out. So this was the Skipper character, and as I mentioned to you guys earlier, this is where the Jolly Roger gang started with these type of aircraft.
So this character resembles your dad's personality?
Yeah, he does in a lot of ways. You know, we briefly talked about how Dad was sort of tough love, and Skipper is very much tough love. You know, at first he's pretty hard on Dusty. But then once he sees that Dusty has, like, the passion and the desire and is ready to sort of almost step out of that comfort zone, Skipper gets on board.
So you're a flatheader. We'll work on that.
Roger that.
How do you think Grandpa Riley would feel about being in the movie?
I've actually thought about that several times and reflected back on it. I think he would feel pretty darn proud.
There were a couple moments during the different research trips we did that really hit home of how cool this whole thing was.
I got to ride in a B-25 World War II bomber. So here we are,
We're in the plane. We're going to be taking off in a little bit. We're going to go for a flight, for about an hour flight, and really see what it was like to feel it and smell it and just immerse ourselves in the overall experience of flying in vintage aircraft.
We got to crawl up to the front of the aircraft where the bombardier's site is. It's not a view I had ever seen flying in any aircraft before, and that was just amazing.
So, guys, this is the B-25 Mitchell. Named after Lieutenant Billy Mitchell. Medium bomber, twin engine. I think it had about a 5-man crew in it. Really cool airplane. I was able to get, you know, part of my research early on in the movie was I was able to take a ride in one of these things, and it was beyond crazy cool. We learned a lot as a team while we were experiencing the flight. The inertia, the weight of the aircraft, the power of the aircraft as it would make a turn and bank and then level out. You need to experience that, to convey that, to get it into your animation to help make it believable. It's that whole weight and size. You know, you have to think about all that kind of stuff when you animate.
We did have, in the beginning, a lot more movement in the air, which made them feel a lot lighter and took a lot of realism out of that flight movement.
The weight and the feel of the planes has to be real, otherwise you're taken out of the character. And you want people not to be paying attention to the weight and feel of the plane so that they can focus on the character.
And one thing that John Lasseter said pretty early on is that when they're flying in the air, they're planes. But when they're on the ground, that's when we can put more character into them.
You are way behind. Thanks, guys. You saved my tail out there.
We were able to actually experience a couple days on board the USS Carl Vinson, which is a nuclear-powered aircraft carrier based out of San Diego.
Landing on the aircraft carrier, nobody was more excited to touch down than Clay.
It was like right out of Top Gun because the steam was rolling off the thing and there was F-18s sitting there ready to go. I mean, it was surreal.
Every little detail was just so exciting to him and he was eating it up. It was fantastic to see.
We have this big moment in the movie when Dusty needs to land on the aircraft carrier. So I was able to take it out to Captain Spitero on the Vinson and actually play him the clip on the aircraft carrier and go, what do you think? Overall, he really, really liked it. He had a couple little tweaks.
He's going to give you that cut, 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 and that's to, you're going to shut your throttles all the way down.
On a few of our shots, our jets have their wings down, and the Navy guys were like, unless they're taken off, the wings are never down on a carrier.
All the shots were done. They're looking at me, and I go, well, we're going to change them. You know, that's a big enough fix. We wanted to make it authentic.
I felt extremely proud and humbled to have been a part of that experience.
And now what they're going to do is they're going to load up camera team in there, but they have two extra seats. So guess what? You guys are going for a ride in the B-25.
Yeah.
Yeah, buddy. So let's hang on and have some fun. This is going to be good. Here we go, getting a chance to fly in a P-51 Mustang. Just unloaded Jack and Luke. They're climbing in the B-25. They're gonna chase us. This is a dream come true.
Clay was right in the middle of it at all time. And he became this expert. And he's so enthusiastic. And then Clay's also a really great storyteller and really crafting this story, the emotion. Because we wanted to have not only humor, but one of the hallmarks of our films is to have heart. And we wanted to have heart in this film of airplanes as characters.
Thanks, Skip. Don't thank me. I learned a lot more from you than you ever learned from me.
To have been this little boy that loved airplanes and also had a passion to draw, and then to have those two worlds sort of collide on this project, to be able to direct a feature-length film starring airplanes with the Walt Disney Company, it's truly
the dream come true.
This is Luke Hull, Clay's son, and I just want to say how proud I am of him, and he's making the family really proud. I mean, this has always been his dream to make his own movie, and I know it means a lot to him, and it means a lot to me that he's done this. He's been a great dad to me, and yeah, I just can't say how proud I am of him.
Jack Hall. It's been pretty amazing to see my dad make this movie. It relates back to how kind of always been into aviation myself, just like him and his dad. Makes me very proud.
This is Clay Hall, and I have to tell you guys that I think I just enjoyed one of the most special days of my life. You know, as a father, being joined with my sons on just an epic flight at sunset, I think this moment, it'll be with me for the rest of my life, and I'm sure it will with my sons as well. It was a special day out here, a special moment, a chance to talk about Grandpa, about aviation, about the movie planes, and most of all, about family.
From above the world of cars, Disney's Planes presents El Chupacabra.
Who is to blame? Who defies gravity? Making gravity back down first. El Chupacabra! Who is the plane who breaks wind? And it stays broken. El Chupacabra! Who is the plane whose mask has its own mask?
Ooh. El Chupacabra.
Who is this plane? This super plane? He goes only by one name. El Chupacabra!
Ay! El Chupacabra? Isn't that the monster that siphons your fuel?
It is a stage name, used to strike fear into the hearts of my opponents. Are you not struck with fear?
Not so much like struck, but like graced with fear.
Oh, yeah, like wicked graced.
Yeah, graced.
If I may continue, por favor? The plane, the myth, legend, El Chupacabra! Seriously?
From above the world of cars, Disney's Planes presents Ripslinger.
Legends aren't born, they're built.
For speed! I am Ripslinger!
10 years ago, air racing needed a new star. So I gave it one. Now I'm known all over the world as a beloved role model and a racing champion. Yet sometimes I feel lost and empty as I look for the answer to life's greatest mystery. Is there an awesome beyond awesome? Or is awesome the most awesome I will ever be? Perhaps I'll never know. Still, onward I quest, ever in pursuit of the one thing I love almost as much as myself.
Victory, baby!
To be this good, it takes velocity, tenacity, and most of all, humility.
Ripslinger!
Produced by Ripslinger Productions, a joint venture of Ripslinger Industries and the Ripslinger Foundation for the Advancement of Ripslinger.
Disney's Planes presents Dusty.
There you go, Captain. Topped off with the finest jet fuel in prop wash junction.
Roger that.
Take care.
Whoa! Don't see that every day, huh, Chug?
Yep, Dusty. An engine that powerful only takes the top-of-the-line jet fuel. It keeps those afterburners blazing.
Ha, awesome.
Well, there you go, Dusty.
Thanks, Chug.
No problem. It's the wrong fuel. Dusty!
On your right!
Whoa!
My fault! Sorry, Thornhill! Uh-oh. No, no, no!
Dusty! Sorry, sorry, sorry. Are you okay? Say something.
That was awesome!
From above the world of cars, Disney's Planes presents Ashani.
No more questions. No more questions. Thank you for coming, everyone. We look forward to seeing you at the race.
Ashani, do you really think the race could be won by a girl?
I said no more questions.
Actually, I'd like to answer that one.
When life shifts into the fast lane, time flies and doesn't stop for any plane. And don't try to beat the boys at their game. It's my sky. They'll never catch me anyway. I fly fast, fly high, fly past, fly by, fly swift, fly true, fly by you. Don't cry, you won't be the first one to sit by and watch as the race is won. I'm not shy as long as my engines run. It's my sky. Show you how this is done. I fly fast, fly high, fly past, fly by, fly swift, fly true, fly by you.
Any more questions?
Yes. I'm good.
Your Disney movies are magic. And the magic continues after the credits. Just look inside your Blu-ray disc or DVD for the magic code to start earning points toward fantastic rewards at DisneyMovieRewards.com. Take flight with Dusty and Pals. From above the world of cars. Join some of your favorite planes on high-flying new adventures. Soar the world skies. And navigate action-packed missions and races in this airborne adventure game. Disney Planes, the video game, exclusively on Nintendo platforms.
come on with me.
It's supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Perfect in every way.
Mary Poppins, get me gone!
When you're with Mary Poppins, suddenly you're in places you've never dreamed of.
This place is home, Papa, Papa. We need some
music.
I know, isn't it fantastic?
This is gonna be some kind of shindig.
Let's go! Fish launch! Woohoo!
After her!
That's it! I'm booking myself on a cruise!
What this means?
Somebody switched our heads!
No. Somebody switched our talents!
Look at all this water.
Tink! I didn't do anything. I just hit it.
Tink, could you stop not doing anything before we drown?
You're a fast-flying fairy now.
And I'm a garden fairy.
Ew, get him off! Looks like I'm an animal fairy now.
It went like clockwork, just as the captain said.
Pirates.
Thank you.